Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Let us pray, Sister
Ebadura. Father, in Jesus' name, King of glory, we exalt your name this morning. We lift you high for the grace you have given us once again to be in your presence. We say, Lord, receive our thanks in Jesus' name. We thank you, Lord, Father, even for the Sunday school class this morning, for what you are going to do in our midst. We exalt your holy name for what you have done, O Lord, even last week, O Lord, the last 2 weeks, for what you have done through this same topic. Lord, receive our thanks in Jesus' name. We commit this class into your hand. Holy Spirit, have your way in our midst in Jesus' name. Even our mommy, you are going to use, O Lord, the unction to function, Father, release upon her in the name of Jesus. And if every one of us, O Lord, Father, you give unto us, O Lord, hearing here and understanding that in Jesus' name, that the word, O Lord, will transform our home, our lives in the mighty name of Jesus. As many on their way coming, O Lord, hasten their feet down here to be a partaker of what you have for us in your word in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord, because you have answered. We bless your holy name. In Jesus' name I pray.
Amen. This morning, we are going to consider causes of conflict in the home.
You see that
about 2 weeks now, we have been considering our topic, family, marriage and family. Marriage and family life of Christian.
Lati bi ose meji nsin la tin gbe yewo akori to wi pe igbeyawo ati igbe aye ebe Christiani.
And I believe that we have learned a lot.
Mo si gbagbo pe ati ko opolopo eko.
But today we want to go a little bit into making it to be practical.
Sugbon loni a fe lo sinu akori eyi to je pe eyi to pa nilo lati fi sinu ise.
And we want to make it to be an interactive lesson.
So if you will be
allowed to ask your question.
We don't want anybody
to shy away from this topic. Because we know that these things that are here are the common things that are causing conflict in our family.
So if
you think you are shy, if you cannot ask the question, you can write it down and send it to our leader. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So let's open our Bible to the book of Peter's.
Eje ki a se bibeli wa sinu iwe Peteru.
We are going to read 1 Peter 3.
Peteru kini ori keta.
1 Peter 3, 1 to 7.
Iwe Peteru kini ori keta lati ese kini si ikeje.
I read.
Onka ni bi.
He said, likewise, wives, be submissive to your own. Likewise, wives, be submissive to your own husbands, so that if any do not obey the word, they without the word may be won by the behavior of the wives. When they observe your pure behavior combined with fear, your admonition should not be outward, as planting the air and wearing of goats, or putting on of clothes, but let it be the hidden person of the heart, and with the impressive quality of a meek and quiet spirit, which is precious in the sight of God. For after this manner, in the former times, the holy women who trusted in God also adorned themselves, being submissive to their own husband, just as Sarah obeyed Abraham, calling him Lord, whose children ye are, if you do right and are not afraid with any terror. Likewise, husband, dwell with your wife with understanding, giving honor to wives as to the weaker vessel, and as heirs together of the grace of life, so that your prayers may not be hindered. I believe that the Yoruba, they have gone through along with us. Say, just as we said this morning, we will see that in the marriage, as we have benefits in the marriage, we also have causes that cause setback by conflicts. We have a lot of them listed here. But this morning we want to dwell on some.
You have married, you and your husband, by grace of God, you understand the Lord.
Some women, they used to report to mommy that even because they normally God used to